Hi, hello friends, welcome to my channel. My channel name is Chemistry Coaching for MCET, MSc, CSIR, UGC. Please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon, give me a like. Here I am providing videos for intermediate students, BSc students, MSc students, PhD students. Present video is very useful for MSc, PhD students. This video explains how to do PhD in India. Let's get into the video. Here I am explaining my thesis work. My thesis title is having total synthesis of polyhectade A, polyhectade B, goniothales diol, 2,5-epi goniothales diol and formal total synthesis of FR252921. So these are the research projects in my PhD. Total synthesis of polyhectade A and polyhectade B from L-malic acid is chapter 1. Total synthesis of goniothales diol and 2,5-epi goniothales diol from D-mannitol is chapter 2. Formal total synthesis of FR252921 is chapter 3. Studies toward the total synthesis of Tamiflu from quinic acid is a project work. So here I am showing the structures of the target molecules. These are the target molecules. First one is polyhectade A. Second one is the same family, polyhectade B. Third one is goniothales diol. Fourth one is epigoniothales diol. Fifth one, FR252921. This is the key intermediate of Tamiflu. So before going to my PhD work, here I am providing some guidelines for PhD people. So first, after qualifying CSIR, everybody is happy. Okay, finally I am succeeded. I got a CSIR UGC. Nowadays people are getting All India rank, whatever it may be, All India rank. So after getting CSIR, you have to choose a supervisor. So if you want to do a PhD, you can join in IITs or nowadays IISER is also available, and you can work in CSIR institutes like IICT, CDR Electron, NCL Pune. So based on after getting CSIR, so you have to choose a supervisor for your research work. So according to my experience and my knowledge, choose a director or head of the department as your supervisor. Why? Because after completion of your PhD and postdoc, they will offer an academic position. But here the condition is your attitude is very important, and the second thing, your CV should be strong. Why? Because if you take a director or head of the department, he is having around 20 students to 30 students. So he will offer an academic position to who is having a good attitude, or we can say good relationship with your supervisor. So the point here is, he is having lot of students. So if he want to offer an academic position to you, so you have to maintain a good relationship with your supervisor, and your CV should be strong. Okay. then after choosing a supervisor, first thing you have to meet your supervisor personally, and you have to discuss with him. You have to tell him, I want to join in your research group. So I'm interested in your research. So I want to join in research group, like that. So then after meeting your supervisor, you have to meet your group members. Why? Because your group members means already they are doing PhD, they are also qualified CSR, and so they also already selected in the interview. So what will happen, they will explain suppose what are the questions appearing in the interview. They will explain the what are the questions and answers which are appearing in the interview. So if you know the questions and answers, it is very easy to attend the interview. So after interview is completed, then you will be selected in a group, or you will be joined in a group. So this joined in a group, then after joining a group, how to work in PhD, that is one important thing. So you have to work with a senior for 6 to 12 months initially. This is called a training period. So once if you work 6 to 12 months with your senior, then what will happen, you will learn suppose like column chromatography, how to do rotavapor, how to put reactions, workup, column packing. So initially first your senior will allot you to do a column chromatography. Slowly you will learn column chromatography. So after doing column chromatography, slowly you will learn rotavapor concentration. After doing rotavapor concentration, after 2-3 months, you will suggest to put reactions followed by workups. So after doing workup, you have to do column packing and column again, and you have to separate the pure compound. Slowly, these are the repeating steps in PhD. So after completion of your training period, suppose you worked on a project with your senior, so you have to ask him, put your name in his publication. Why? Because getting one or two publications with your senior is very important. So after completion of one year, you will start your own thesis work. Here thesis work. So after starting your thesis work, slowly, day by day, day goes on, you will learn with how to use Reaxys, Skyfinder, retrosynthesis, scheme design. You are familiar with all these things. So after getting a lot of experience after 3 years, so you have to provide work around 3 to 5 juniors or more. Why? Because after providing work, you have to help them. If they got any problem, you have to suggest new route, or you have to help them. Sometimes you have to do a fragment for them. And after helping them, you have to help them to complete the project. So after completion of the project, automatically they will put your name in their publication. So if you get 5 publications around from your juniors, it will be helpful for your CV. And simultaneously you will work on your own project. Suppose in PhD generally, a synthetic PhD student can do 3 or 4 project maximum. So you will get around 3 publications or 4 publications. So if you work alone, you will get 4 publications, one from senior and 5 from your junior. Then totally you will get around 10 publications. But how many publications you are getting is depends on how much work you are providing to your juniors is very important. Here teamwork is very important. If you work alone, you will get 3 or 4 publications only. So if you work with juniors or many juniors, you are providing work to many juniors, so you will get more publications, your CV will be strong. Okay, next I'm explaining my PhD journey. So what happened is August 2005. So here I'm writing the date. August 2005, I joined in IACT as a PhD student, August 2005. So August 2005. So what after joining in IACT, I got a project. In generally, how CSR DST assign projects to IACT? So here the director will assign the projects to different groups or different scientists. Scientist assigns the project to students. So in the time in 2005, swine flu is spreading around the world like corona. So here Tamiflu is a hot molecule in 2005. So in 2005, this is the Tamiflu molecule. So this is a Tamiflu molecule, very hard molecule. So it is a drug to treat swine flu. So at that time, we got this project. So this is called quinic acid. The starting material name is here. I'm showing. This is the starting material. So starting material name is quinic acid. So we have to take quinic acid and we have to treat with 2,2-DMP. And PTSA. So 2,2-DMP PTSA, this diol will react with 2,2-DMP, it will form acetonide. So here under acid catalyzed intramolecular esterification is taking place. So here two steps are taking, first acetonide formation and lactone formation in step one. So in step two, what we are doing is we are treating, suppose this compound two is compound 2, we are treating with K2CO3 methanol. So we are treating compound 2 with ethanol. What is happening is, first here trans esterification is taking place. Trans esterification means one of the ester group is replaced with solvent molecule and it will result ester moiety. So here the external ethanol molecule is added to the carbonyl, you are forming ester, and alcohol is forming. So after doing K2CO3 ethanol, you will get ester and alcohol. This is alcohol and you are getting ester. So after getting compound, for suppose I am giving this compound number 3. So compound 3 is treated with pivolyl chloride pyridine. You are getting pivolyl protection at this position. Why? Because this is a secondary alcohol, this is a tertiary alcohol. Secondary alcohol is more reactive compared to tertiary alcohol. So secondary reactive alcohol is protected and you are getting tertiary alcohol free. So after getting this compound, the suppose for compound number 4 is treated with DMF POCl3. So OH react with POCl3, form a leaving group, and under heating condition you will get a double bond. Means you will get compound 5. So compound 5 treating with 50% acetic acid, here acetonide group is removed and you are getting diol. So this is you are getting compound 6. Here you are getting generating diol. This compound 6 is treated with thionyl chloride. You are getting here compound 7, this is called cyclic sulfite. So diol is treated with thionyl chloride, you are getting cyclic sulfite. So after treating the cyclic sulfite with sodium azide, here azide is attacking from top face and your cyclic sulfite will open, you will get azido alcohol. So why? Because here this is the allylic position. So you can attack the azide from anywhere, from here and here. But both the possibilities are there, but the allylic positions are generally active. This is I am putting star mark. So this is allylic position, this is more active, this is not active. So allylic position is more reactive. So azide is attacking from top face, results azido alcohol. So azido alcohol on treating with TPP, you will get azidine ring. Azido alcohol will first azide will convert to amine will attack on the OH, you will get a 3-membered azidine ring. Followed by treatment with tetyl chloride, amine production is taking place. You are getting N-tetyl. So you are getting N-tetyl. So after getting this compound 9, So we are treating this component with a tripentanol. After treating this compound with the tripentanol, in the same way this is allylic position opened here, you will get the tripentanol is attacking here from bottom phase, results the key intermediate of this product. So this is very important. You are getting this compound. After getting this compound, you have to convert this, you have to remove the O-pivolyl, you have to get OH, and we have to convert the OH into O-tosyl and attack of azide. Azide, we have to convert azide to amine followed by treating with HCl. So around 5 steps are there, but at this stage we stopped this project and unable to finish the target molecule. For doing this project, already it has taken around 1 year 2 months. So I am also a little bit confused, and already 1 year completed. I am also a little bit tension, because all people are doing thesis work, my work is not started, so I am a little bit confused. So finally I got a project means is a thesis work. So initial days your supervisor will provide a target molecule for you. So here gonadiol is diol 1, gonadiol is diol 2, it is a small molecule. So initially you are new to PhD, so they will provide target molecule and with the scheme. So you have to work on this project. Slowly I started this project. In general, we will take a molecule which is having some activity. So these molecules are isolated from here, goniothalamus bornus tree bark extract. It is showing strong cytotoxic activity against P388 mouse leukemia cells and strong insecticidal activities. Here I am discussing with the retrosynthesis. So here compound 1 is synthesized from this alcohol, furan ring with the alcohol. So this furan ring we can easily synthesize from d-mannitol. So this synthesis of furan from d-mannitol is well established in our laboratory. So in the same way, compound 2 also synthesized from this furano alcohol. This furan ring we can easily synthesize from d-mannitol. So we have to take d-mannitol and do some functional group manipulations, you will get the furan compound. So here the retrosynthesis. If we go to the synthesis, total synthesis of goniostyl diol. So first you have to take d-mannitol. So first you have to take d-mannitol. So d-mannitol is all hydroxys are free, OH 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you treat d-mannitol with 2,2-DMP, so you will get first mannitol diastinide. So after getting mannitol diastinide, what you have to do? We have to do this hydroxyl protection using benzyl bromide sodium hydride. So after getting this compound, you have to treat this compound with small amount of HCl and in methanol, you will get the one of the esterase is open, you will get the diol. So this diol is treated with sodium pyrite, you will get aldehyde. So in reagents you are studying about what is the role of pyrite. So after getting aldehyde here, you have to treat with phenyl magnesium bromide. Aldehyde in general, if you react with Rignard generally react with aldehyde, use the alcohol here. So you are getting alcohol. So DMP is a reagent used for oxidation. So DMP is a reagent used for oxidation. So this alcohol is converted into keto. So this keto compound, so for suppose I am giving 2, 3, 4. This is compound 4. For keto compound, you will take the number 4. This compound, keto compound 4, treated with zinc borohydrate. Zinc borohydrate, this is zinc borohydrate. After taking with zinc borohydrate, you will get compound A. This is 1,2 antichemistry. Here, for selectivity, please go through the Cram's rule and apply the Cram's rule here. You will get the selectivity here. So, compound 5 here, it is treated with benzyl chloride, triethylamine DMAP. This alcohol is converted into ester. So ester, this is the PCO OBZ. So suppose you take compound number 5. So treatment the compound 5 with the CSA. CSA means camphor sulfonic acid. So it will provide a proton. So this ester will remove, you will get the diol compound. So you will get the diol compound here. So if you treat diol compound with tosyl chloride, triethylamine, DMAP, first of all, what will happen here? Primary hydroxy is protecting. The reason is very simple. In generally, primary alkyls are very reactive compared to secondary. So primary alkyl is protected and secondary alkyl is free. So this compound, first you are treating with K2CO3 methanol. Here is K2CO3. So if you treat this compound with K2CO3 methanol, what will happen is, first you will get your epoxide. First you will get epoxide here. So like epoxide formation place taking place. Suppose here I am showing the intermediate. It is very difficult to show. So first epoxide formation is taking place under K2CO3 condition. This will take hydrolysis taking place. So I am showing you, suppose after hydrolysis you will get O-. This O- ion will attack on this carbon. This is in the epoxide form. So this hydroxy will attack here and this epoxide will open. You will get this alcohol. So please go through the Baldwin rules. Why? Because this is 5-hexo attack. 5-hexo attack results opening of the epoxide. You will get the furan alcohol. So if you go through the Baldwin rules, you will get the clear conclusion. So this alcohol is subjected to DMP oxidation. You will get aldehyde. So after treating the aldehyde with 2-carbon wetting, you will get compound 9. In wetting reaction, in general, alpha beta unsaturated esters are forming here. So treating this compound 9 with palladium block, so double bond is reduced and benzyl groups are removed. You are getting target molecule 1. So here for here this scheme is very good. I didn't get any problem. For the synthesis of epigonioethyls diol, I have taken the compound A after zinc borate reduction. See previous slide. After treating with the compound A with methyl chloride triethylamine, you will get O-methyl compound here. So O-methyl, O-benzyl. Suppose if you take this compound number 10, so treating with this compound 10 with the CSA is proton source will remove the estrogen. You will get alcohol here. What will happen is this alcohol will react with attack on this position. Why? Because it is SN2 attack. This alcohol will attack on the O-methyl is acting as a leaving group, results a furan ring formation. Furan ring, you do get a furan ring. So please go through the stereochemistry. So after you are getting furan alcohol, this alcohol is oxidized using DMP. So DMP will do oxidation conversion of alcohol to aldehydes. So treating with the aldehyde with 2-carbon wetting, here wetting reaction taking place, you are getting alpha beta unsaturated ester. So this alpha beta unsaturated ester is treating with palladium block. So hydro double bond is reduced, benzyls are removed. You are getting the target molecule 2. So this is the target molecule 2. So finally I got a publication in 2007. So after joining in August 2005, 2006 is over. In 2007 I got a publication. So maybe around in 2007, like 2007 March or like that, in 2007 March I got a publication. So slowly after 1.5 year I got a single one publication. So here, thank you.